Fort Rye with ElectricBikeReview.com here at Interbike and stumbled across YikeBike all the way from New Zealand, it sounds like. So tell me about this bike.
It's designed, made, implemented, everything. It's done in New Zealand.
Wow.
We're just starting to sell globally, and this is one of our production models.
You know, New Zealand is a fun place, and this looks like a fun bike. How much does this weigh?
This one here is just under 30 pounds. And we can make them a lot lighter. Obviously, if you have a carbon fiber bike, it's going to be down to around about 23 pounds. So this one's a bit of a mixture.
So what are the specs? You know, we're always talking about watts on electric bike motor, and that gives you an idea of like how strong it is.
Well, this is we're not too worried about the spec here. The performance is not related to spec so much. People don't understand specs. Who cares what it is? They don't know that. But if we tell them, look, it'll do, you know, 14 miles an hour, they get that. And it will go for about 6 miles. They understand that.
Yeah.
At the end of 6 miles, you're going to have to charge it. It'll take about 50 or 60 minutes. They understand
not
that.
Too bad. Is this a lithium battery then?
Yes, it's a lithium battery. We've got options.
You and me, we're pretty fit. We're lightweight guys, not like super big. So will it still get that kind of performance?
Oh, yeah. It doesn't change the performance much. It's basically electric motors are like that. So in terms of, there are some weight and height restrictions like there are on anything. So, you know, a great big guy, 250 pounds, is going to struggle with it. Probably more to do with balance and managing it than the bike's performance.
So I see like one wheel, and I mean, how can you show me how this thing rides?
This is its folded up size, and it's designed to be picked up by the seat here and just carried upstairs if you need to.
Okay.
And if you want to unfold it, it's a pretty quick process.
Wow.
That's all there is to unfolding it. Locks in place. There's a switch to turn everything on.
Okay.
Sit on like that. It's got a throttle. It's got a brake. It's got indicators left and right. It's got a wee horn. It's got anti-lock, anti-skid brake, regenerative front wheel. Yeah. And if once you want to go, you simply pull on the throttle. And off you go.
Oh boy. Can you show us the horn?
The horn's pretty quiet for in here. It's just to warn people that
just kind of a beeper. It's kind of like a bell.
It's a beeper, just to say, look, we're coming up behind you.
The indicators. The lights are great, so you don't get hit by
a... You're not going to get run over by a car. Left and right indicators. In fact, if you hold them both on, it'll give you flashing lights.
Is the seat adjustable up and down?
This is it. One size fits all.
One size fits all.
Most people, you know, unless you're really short, you're not gonna have any real problems.
It's interesting. There's a hole, right? I mean, is that just for style, or
that's spare wheel goes. That's where the back wheel goes when it folds up. If you want to see it folded up again, you'll see it just falls into place.
Where do you put your water bottle?
You got a pack. Who hasn't got a pack? Everybody has a pack.
Well, clearly, this bike doesn't have everything, but that's part of the benefit. It's lighter,
yep.
Right? It's got the regenerative braking, it's got a decent amount of range, you carry it right up to your office, you don't have to worry about people stealing it.
Yeah, they're not going to pinch it, you put it under your desk, it's charged while you're having your lunch, and you're off home again.
Is this a...
That's pneumatic, so it's got air in it,
yeah,
60
okay.
pounds, the back one's a solid tyre, so you're really little trouble with flat tyres, you're not going to get a flat. You can buy a flight case that this fits in, which is like a travel case.
Yeah.
And when you get to the other end, you can simply unfold that case and it becomes a trailer if you want it to.
Wow.
So you can trailer along and put your shopping.
How much does this thing cost then? You know, here in we're in America right now for Interbike.
You guys are always worried about the money.
Well, I mean, you know, we gotta get to work.
Yeah. Look, it's around about $2,200 to $2,300. Plus your taxes, that's for the heavy model, up to about $3,900 for the lighter weight model.
That's a carbon model.
Carbon.
So is this the carbon or is this the...
This is part carbon and part polymer.
So this is some sort of in-between.
Yeah, I've put this together for myself to have some fun on, you know. So there's an aluminium or our composite model, and then there's the lightweight go faster carbon model.
Do you invent this thing?
No fear. The inventor's a smart guy in New Zealand. There's a few of them down there. In fact, a lot of smart guys down there. They're more than just sheep. And Grant Ryan's done a lot of work getting it to this shape. And I'm the sales guy. I've come along here to get around and tell them.
Well, would you mind if I sat on it?
You can do what you want.
Hold the microphone for a second.
Yeah. What's under that? There's the accelerator under there, so be careful. So this is the throttle. And you just gently squeeze it, and this is the brake on that side.
Okay.
And if you gently squeeze that, it will take off. So you put all your weight on your bottom, not on your shoulders, one foot on. You look down the road, not down here, and it should go. It won't be easy. It takes a couple of goes.
Okay, let's give it a try.
Wow, I think he's... That worked.
Hope he comes back.
I don't know if he's going to come back. Oh, look at this guy. Wow.
gender breaking.
Hey.
Yeah.
You did that.
Yeah, it doesn't take, it's not too bad, you know. It does take a second to kind of get used to sitting like this, but very unique and innovative design here. I really appreciate your time, Alan.
Well, thank you, Tom.
This is the YikeBike.
YikeBike.
Awesome.
I'll hold it up for you.
Yeah, let's see that again.
Okay. It takes a long time to fold it.
That's awesome. And is it called the, so I remember there was like, there's this Nickelodeon show called like, Real Monsters, and there was like a character named like Yikes or something like that. Is that how it got the name?
No, I think just Yikes is a bit of a New Zealand thing. When you see something strange, you go, Yikes, what's that? You
know,
it's gotta happen like that guy. Yikes, it's just a cool name really, it does.
A lot of people riding these around there?
Yeah, look, it's commuters, last milers, people who get off public transport and they want to go last mile to the office because it's safe inside, and then the first mile to your transport, guys with yachts, you know, yachties, it's easy to put on the yacht, private aircraft, and then just guys with a bit of dough who say, wow, this is cool, I want one.
That's cool, I do want one.
That'd be a deal for that, mate.
Sweet, thank you.
Okay, see you later.